I didn't think I'd be living in a time where we would have to have arguments about tyranny, actually.
You know, people are arguing about whether they should get vaccinated or not. Have you gotten vaccinated?
Yeah, I'm up for it too.
I've been trying to tell everybody not to point fingers, but to say, like, we have a real problem here unless we can just be really honest.
And we miss the big picture of what's really going on.
I was not entirely sure if I really want to do a video on this topic, but during the last days I felt a growing urge to do it based on what I've experienced as someone who is currently not vaccinated against corona. So here we go. When I look into the eyes of others, I see people realizing that by now, corona and vaccination has become a topic which can be barely addressed without a lack of clarity or sensitivity. I see people who are divided by one another due to different views on politics or ideologies. I see people who are so focused on these differences that they completely forget about our commonalities. I also see people who have opposing opinions, but they are still able to see the person behind those opinions and our shared humanity. I see people who are about to lose their job due to the consequences of lockdowns. I also see people who are about to lose their job due to consequences of vaccine mandates. I see people having reasonable concerns when others do not get tested, when they have loved ones that are at serious risk. At the same time, I see people who have reasonable concerns to get vaccinated because of medical reasons. So, how do you know whether someone has an ill parent? How do you know whether someone has an autoimmune disease? How do you know what is good for others? After approximately 2 years, I see people on both sides being completely tired of all of this. People full of fear and frustration. People who are scared of losing their freedom, who want to show this by demonstrating in the streets against vaccine mandates, but on the same time being scared of being judged or discriminated by good friends or family members. At the same time, I see those friends or family members just shaking their heads and thinking, how can you be so selfish? Their faces are full of disappointment or even hate. I see people who are kind and gentle becoming inhumane towards others. People losing touch with their natural sense of compassion and understanding. I see people on both sides clinging so intensely to this fear that they almost become one with it, saying things at the cost of others. I also see people who recognize this underlying fear and try to acknowledge it without acting on it. I see people understanding and genuinely acting. I also see people ignoring and impulsively and defensively reacting. I see people acting from a place of fear. I see people acting from a place of love. I see myself in both of those states, swinging from one extreme to the other. Love, sensitivity, understanding and humanity. Fear, confusion, mistrust and hostility. I see people who openly address critical points on the government's action regarding corona being labeled as anti-vaxxers or conspiracy theorists, that they are delusional, psychotic, or should be punished. On both sides, I see people's first to inform other people and sharing their personal opinion. And when people think, how can they be so dumb? Don't they see that they are wrong?
talking about where we could be going with this kind of technological division of society.
I see other people's biases. I also see my own ones, our tendency to seek information which confirms already existing beliefs. I see scientists who cannot explain why certain countries with high levels of vaccination, such as Israel or Ireland, are also having very high COVID infection rates. I see people saying that the unvaxxed are dangerous for others and that the vaxxed ones should be protected from them. At the same time, I see people who doubt the effectiveness of vaccines, using those kind of facts to back up their conspiracy theories, while other people who are entirely convinced of the effectiveness of the vaccines simply disregard those facts. After over 3 years of studying psychology, I see myself questioning the existence of certain scientific values and guidelines, such as transparency. Nevertheless, I still see many scientists trying to encourage an open debate, but at the same time, I see Google's algorithms suppressing inconvenient data, the arm of mainstream social media reaching out to more and more people while censoring critical but actually valuable information. I see people on both sides making false or unscientific claims about corona and vaccines, but being entirely confident that they are right, or at least pretending to do so. At the same time, I see people using fancy terms and elegantly discussing peer-reviewed studies without knowing how to interpret the data, without being aware of cherry-picking articles, and without realizing that they rely on arguments of so-called fake experts. I see people complaining about a dishonest society without a proper public debate. I also see people accusingly looking at me when I question whether some of the actions that have been taken by the government can be actually really ethically or scientifically justified.
This virus and the reaction to it has revealed this great spiritual void.
If we have two opposing emotions, we also have opposing opinions and stories. Two opposing groups who see each other as enemies, and the whole thing is reinforced by the media, government, and almost the entire society. I see those two polarities emerging, but nothing really in between. Are there also less extreme arguments? In the beginning, it was all people against corona. Now, vaccinated people against unvaccinated people. Or let me rather say good people versus bad people, safe versus dangerous ones, responsible versus irresponsible ones. The introduction of vaccine passports and mandates created a huge societal gap, and this cannot be denied. Still, I find people who are entirely confident of the contrary and say this is the only way to go. So you need to decide on what side you are standing, and there's nothing really in between, and the pressure increases. If I try to distance myself from my own biased point of view, I can clearly see that both sides, both of those stories, make clearly sense if one identifies with those arguments. But at the same time, I see that those two stories are just too different to be united. I see people talking about the unvaxxed and vaxxed ones, but rarely talking about human beings in general or how to support each other. Because this can only happen when people are able to distance themselves from their own stories, which are mostly fueled by fear, that they are able to understand the fears and thoughts of the other side. I see all of those things in other people. I also see all of those things within myself. Honestly, I'm not too concerned where you position yourself on this debate, But if you agree that understanding and humanity should be valued, then please leave a like here and share the video with others to, let's say, facilitate healthier conversations. My name is Till, and this is Till Talk.